So the simplest way for me to think about the futures market is this. You want to think about it as it's a market where we establish prices for commodities, in this case cattle, that are going to be delivered at a later date. So for example, right now there is an August feeder cattle futures contract that's trading on the board. And you can think of that as a price expectation for the month of August. So when you think about the live cattle futures contract, understand that those are fed cattle, or what we might call slaughter cattle. So those are cattle that are coming off feed and ready to be harvested. Feeder cattle futures are for heavy feeder cattle that are ready to be placed on feed. And this is the one that has the most impact on Kentucky producers and impacts our local markets here in the state. So the first thing to understand is that when you see that futures price, that's for a specific quantity of cattle. In the case of feeder cattle, we're talking about 50,000 pounds, so what a semi-truck holds. So 50,000 pounds of feeder cattle. The weight range on those is between 700 and 900 pounds. They are steers, and they're medium and large frame number ones and twos. Now, the next thing they want to understand is location. Feeder cattle futures contracts are cash settled to actual cattle sales in 12 major cattle producing states. So think about the central part of the U.S., from the southern plains up to the northern plains. So that 800 pound, medium large frame number one and two steer, he's somewhere in the central part of the United States where the larger feedlot areas are. First thing to understand is why do Kentucky feeder cattle prices sell for less than feeder cattle in the western part of the country? Simple answer is transportation cost. That's where most of the feedlots are. So most of our feeder cattle in Kentucky are gonna move out west to be placed on feed. So our cattle of similar weight and grade are gonna sell for less than feeder cattle prices out west because ours have got to be transported out there. But if we understand that the same factors that impact feeder cattle prices out west also impact Kentucky feeder cattle prices, we also know that things that impact the futures market should impact Kentucky markets similarly. So while our prices may not always match futures markets perfectly, they should move together, which allows us to use them for some sense of price direction and forecasting. So if we've got markets that move in the same direction, in this case the futures market and the Kentucky market, people that are large enough and move large enough quantities of feeder cattle can actually sell a futures contract where they can make money on that contract if prices go down. And that would offset the fact that if those prices do go down, their value of their cattle in Kentucky decreases as well. So the futures market provides us a sense for both market direction and in some cases a way to actually protect ourselves from downside price risk.